bow down prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. My brothers, we have to remember, we have to follow the pious predecessors, not only Salaf. You know, the word Salaf means those that have come before us. Yes. Abu Jahl is in the Salaf too. مجموع الفتاوى عقيدة الواسطية اعتصام لسان العرب التفسير الكبير فتح الباري تفسير القرطبي التفسير الكبير تفسير البيضاوي محفظ الأحوذي بشرح جامع الترمذي إتقان شرح كتاب الفقه الأكبر السنة الترمذي أصول السنة إحياء علوم الدين سير أعلام النبلاء تفسير الطبري صحيح البخاري البداية والنهاية. Now the humans say we stop where Allah stops. They don't stop where Allah stops. They give the richer meaning. Wait, dictionary in the word says that hun means take the hun in the richer meaning, but say it's not body. The exact akida is Allah is above the throne. Why on earth are they given those narrations where it's mentioned Allah is in the sky? If you say Allah's got a hun in the richer meaning, there's no point saying kama yaliqu bi sha'ni, which fits His Majesty, because it doesn't fit His Majesty. The true creed of our pious predecessors regarding these sifat is tafreeb al-ma'na wa nafi al-kayf, to leave the meaning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to deny modality and the howness.
On page 24, this Ad-Darimi guy, in the same book, which these people admire, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has got a limit. There are many evidences that Allah has got a limit, had. And whoever refuses and doesn't acknowledge that Allah has a limit, faqad kafir, he's a kafir. That Allah will make the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sit next to him on the arsh, on the throne. And he stopped there. And he said, Imam Tabri has said this. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim. Imam Tabri has mentioned this narration, only one narration. And then he's refuted this narration and he's mentioned the authentic narration, which Imam Ibn Qayyim forgot to mention inside his ijtima'. So Imam Ibn Qayyim, wherever he's mentioned al-ulu al-hissi, he has clearly gone against Imam Tabri rahimahullah. We can criticize that we use weak ahadith in faza'il. These people, without a doubt, they use weak and fabricate ahadith inside aqidah. Bihamdillahi ta'ala, so far we've reached the conclusion that istiwa ala al-arsh, that Allah being above His throne down here, is referring to status elevation. And copious evidences were given from Hafiz ibn Hajar Asqalani, Imam Bayhaqi, Qadi Iyad, and others. And none from the true Salaf have taken the word istiwa in the meaning of istiqrar, to settle, like Ibn Uthaymeen has, and falsely attributed it towards the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Neither does istiwa mean to sit, like Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Qayyim and others have. One other quote before moving on to Imam Ibn Qayyim's book Ijtima' al-Jewish al-Islamiyyah, I would like to give a quote from Al-Milal wal-Nihal. This I have in front of me, Al-Milal wal-Nihal, by the Allama Shirastani, the famous scholar. In here he has mentioned, on page 99, that Al-Karamiyya, the deviated sect, they are the followers of Abu Abdullah bin Muhammad bin Karam. And Abu Abdullah, he was the one who clearly mentioned أن معبوده على الأرش استقرارا, that he is above his throne, settling, and that he is in a direction, fawqa dhatan, status, elevation, sensory elevation, sorry. So, my brothers, we have to remember, we have to follow the pious predecessors. Amongst the predecessors, those that have passed before us, the Salaf, there were many deviated individuals also. So he was amongst the deviated people, and he came out with this ideology that Allah is above His throne with this being, and that He is settling. And the people today, the brothers who attribute themselves towards the pious Salaf, in actual fact, they are linked and connected with this person, Abu Abdullah bin Muhammad bin Karam, who was from the leader and the pioneer to the deviated sect Al-Karamiyya. He further mentions, وَصَارَ مُتَأَخِرُونَ مِنْهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَنَّهُ تَعَالَى بِجِهَةٍ فَوْقٍ وَمُحَاذٍ لِلْعَرْشِ, that amongst the latter people, those that came after him, they have said that Allah is in a direction above his throne and that he is touching the arsh. Then he further mentions amongst the anthropomorphists, some are those who have established 6 directions for Allah, some are those who have established 5 directions, and all of them have unanimously agreed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, many hawadith, many those things that originate can occur with the being of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this aqeedah, if you realize, this is the aqeedah of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah and Imam Ibn Qayyim. This aqeedah of the pioneer and the leader of the deviated sect Karamiyyah, all his aqaid, they all match with the aqeedah of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah and Imam Ibn Qayyim and their books of aqeedah. I would like to mention now regarding Imam Ibn Qayyim. Imam Ibn Qayyim, he has written a book, Ijtima' Jush al-Islamiyyah. And this book is highly recommended in the chapter of Aqeedah. And you will say, you will hear people, mashallah, with a lot of confidence and a lot of pride that alhamdulillah, this is a great book in Aqeedah and we should all read this in Aqeedah. I would like to make this very clear that this book has weak fabricated ahadith, number one. He has interpolations, he has things misquoted from the likes of Imam Tabri rahimahullah. We get criticized that we use weak ahadith in Faza'il. These people, without a doubt, they use weak and fabricate ahadith inside Aqeedah. They misquote people. They go to an extent, they'll even quote the Bible to prove the Aqeedah. They'll quote the Bible to prove the Aqeedah. Inshallah, quotes on this will be given. Ibn Taymiyyah has quoted the Bible, the correct version of the Bible. Allahu alam where that exists. But the correct version of the Bible to prove the Aqeedah. And one other thing before I go into the Aqeedah is I would like to mention that Imam Ibn Qayyim, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, we don't want to expose them. They were pious people. But they had stumbled on many issues related with Aqaid. And the scholars of that time, they had refuted them. And scholars who have come after. And it is necessary for us to inform the Ummah that the true creed of the Salaf was something else. And not those people who today say and project their Aqeedah onto their pious predecessors. So Imam Ibn Qayyim, apart from fabricating ahadith inside his Ijtima' al-Jush al-Islamiyyah, one other thing which he has done, mashallah, very well, inside his Ijtima' al-Jush al-Islamiyyah, that he's quoted the great Imam Tabari rahimahullah out of context. In page 148, he has mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above his throne, al-ulu al-hissi, sensory elevation. Now let's match his aqeedah with Imam Tabari rahimahullah. And he's many places quoted Tabari. Let's go to the actual manuscript of Imam Tabari rahimahullah tafsir and see whether Imam Tabari rahimahullah has really mentioned sensory elevation or status elevation. Inshallah, the listeners today can decide for themselves. Quote number one, At-Tafsir al-Tabari. Quote number one, At-Tafsir al-Tabari. Volume 3. Under the verse, Ayatul Kursi. وهو العلي الله سبحانه وتعالى is العلي أي ذو العلو والارتفاع على خلقه بقدرته. That he is above his creation with his power, not being, not that, not hissi like Imam Ibn Qayyim has mentioned. Quote number two from Tafsir al-Tabari. This I have volume number one in front of me. Imam Tabari has mentioned عَلَىٰ عَلِيْهَا عُلُوُّ وَمَكَانِ وَسُلْطَانِ. That Allah is above his creation with the elevation as a kingdom and mulk, kingdom, and sultan, power. Not the elevation of intiqal and zawal, movement and zawal, to move away from things, to finish, to disappear. Second quote. Third quote I would like to give from Tafsir al-Tabari is volume number 5. Volume number 5. Under the verse of وهو القاهر فوق عباده سورة الأنعام فهو فوقهم بقهره إياهم. He is above them with his power. وهم دونه, and they below Allah in their power. They have less power. They are less in strength. They are weak and feeble. This is quote number. What's quote number? 3. Quote number 4. volume number 11 of Imam Tabari rahimahullah, he has mentioned under Surah Shura that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he dhu ulu wa irtifa ala kulli shay, he is above everything and everything is beneath him. لِأَنَّهُمْ فِي سُلْطَانِهِ, because they are in the kingdom of Allah. جَارِيَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ قُدْرَتُهُ, upon them his qudra, his power is established. مَاضِيَ فِيهِمْ مَشِيئَتُهُ, and his wish and his will is within the creation. He decides however he wishes with regards to his creation. So there are many other places, these are four places I've only give. There are many other places inside At-Tafsir At-Tabari where Imam Tabari rahimahullah has clearly mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above his creation with his power, with his status, and he's referring to status elevation, not sensory elevation. So Imam Ibn Qayyim, wherever he's mentioned Al-Ulu Al-Hissi, he has clearly gone against Imam Tabari rahimahullah. These are only four or five I've given. Another place where Imam Ibn Qayyim has misquoted Imam Tabari out of context and misled his followers, in which they are the result and state they are in today, is Ijtima' Juyush Islamiyya, page 148. He has mentioned waqal, and Imam Tabari rahimullah has mentioned. He has mentioned this. Asa an yab'athaka rabbuka maqaman mahmuda, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, addressing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he will raise him upon the maqam mahmud, the place which has been is praiseworthy, mahmud. Then he's mentioned qal, Imam Tabari has said, yujlisuhu ma'ahu 'ala al-'arsh, that Allah will make the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sit next to him on the arsh, on the throne. And he stopped there. And he said, Imam Tabari has said this. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim. Imam Tabari has mentioned this narration, only one narration. And then he's refuted this narration and he's mentioned the authentic narration, which Imam Ibn Qayyim forgot to mention inside his ijtima'. Thus, I have this in front of me. Volume number 8, Tafsir al-Tabari, where Imam Tabari has mentioned the narrations regarding Maqam Mahmud, the place of praiseworthy. In there he's given narrations. One is the one that Imam Ibn Qayyim has mentioned, and he stopped there. Why? Because this was according to his aqeedah and creed. And he forgot to mention the other narrations, which regarding Imam Tabari himself says, وَأُولَ الْقَوْلَيْنِ فِي ذَلِكْ بِالصَّوَابِ مَا صَحَّ بِهِ الْخَبْرُ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Surah Isra, under the verse Asa an yab'athaka, he has mentioned that the most authentic narration are the two, i.e. Allah making the Prophet sit next to him, number one, and the second, the first one is shifa'ah. Maqam Mahmud Dauni means shifa'ah, that Allah will give the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam permission to intercede. This is one narration. And the other narration is Maqam Mahmud, that Allah will make the Prophet sit next to him. So Imam Tabari has mentioned the first one, i.e. the one regarding Shifa'ah, that Allah will give him the permission to intercede. This is the authentic one. The other narration, Imam Tabari has only mentioned one narration, which is weak and fabricated and rejected by the Ummah. That's why in Jami al-Bayan, Imam Ibn Abdul Bar al-Malik has mentioned that there are two narrations which Imam Mujahid has mentioned inside his works which are rejected by the Ummah. One is this one, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will sit next to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This has been rejected by the Ahli Ilm. And even Imam Tabari himself is saying that is not authentic. The authentic interpretation of Maqam Mahmud, the place praiseworthy, is the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Similarly, Albani Sahib himself in Mukhtasar al-Ulu, Albani Sahib on page 16, he has mentioned himself that the narration regarding the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being seated next to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is weak and this is not correct. The correct interpretation is ash-shifa. So Ibn Qayyim again has misled his people by only quoting one part of the narrative, one narration and failed to mention the other authentic narrations regarding Shafa'ah. And the reason he only mentioned this narration, because this narration of sitting on the throne with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this aqeedah is the aqeedah of Ibn Taymiyyah, his ustad, is the aqeedah of his student Ibn Qayyim, and is the aqeedah of all those scholars who falsely attribute themselves towards the pious predecessors. Moving further. Regarding the same book, which the brothers today, mashallah ta'ala, will advise you, will give you targheeb, that akhi, this book, Ijtimal Yush Islamiyya, is one of its kind. Let's just analyze this book and see how good this book is. In Ijtimal Yush Islamiyya, page 173, Imam Ibn Qayyim has mentioned on the authority of his Shaykh, Shaykhul Islam. Allahu Alam, he might be Shaykhul Islam, but is there Shaykhul Islam for definite? If we call Imam Abu Hanifa Imam al-Azam, then it's very difficult for them to digest. Even though the likes of Alama Zahabi and Ibn Abdul Barr al-Malik have called him Imam al-Azam, but they will get digest, they were able to digest it, and they'll say Imam al-Azam is supposed to be Imam Abu Imam Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The greatest Imam supposed to be the who? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when it comes to say Shaykhul Islam, the Shaykh of entire Islam, then it's okay to say is Ibn Taymiyyah, who came 700 years later. Why can't we call Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam Shaykhul Islam? Call the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam Shaykhul Islam. Don't call Ibn Taymiyyah Shaykhul Islam. Khair, this is something that just came to my mind. In Ijtima'ul Yush al-Islamiyya, on page 173, Imam Ibn Qayyim, whilst exaggerating in praising the innovator, which innovator am I referring to? Abu Sa'id Uthman bin Sa'id Ad-Darimi. Abu Sa'id Uthman bin Sa'id Ad-Darimi. And he is not the Darimi who's written the book of Hadith. Remember this. Abu Sa'id Uthman bin Sa'id Ad-Darimi is the Mujassim, the anthropomorphist, the mubtadi', the innovator, and the person, the great muhaddith who had written the book of Sunan, his name is Abdullah bin Abdul Rahman. Abdullah bin Abdul Rahman al-Darimi. This Darimi is a different Darimi, whom Imam Ibn Taymiyyah greatly admires, mashallah. So Imam Ibn Qayyim is mentioning inside the book of Aqidah that our Shaykh, Shaykhul Islam, our Shaykh, Shaykhul Islam will advise us to read the two books of this Darimi. Which Darimi? Abu Sa'id, the Mujassim, the anthropomorphist Darimi. Our Shaykhul Islam will advise us to read his books. Ashadda al-Wasiyya will greatly and with great emphasis advise us. Wa yu'azzimuhuma jiddan. And he will greatly honor the two books of this anthropomorphist Ad-Darimi. And he would say that inside this, there is Tawheed of Allah. And this greatly explained, he has greatly explained the Asma and the Sifat. And every single student of Sunnah, every single student of Sunnah, he should read this book. Why? Because inside his books is the Aqeedah of the Sahaba and the Tabi'un and the A'immah. Subhanallah. So Imam Ibn Qayyim is saying that my Ustaz Shaykhul Islam said, read the books of who? Abu Sa'id Ad-Darimi. Two of his books. Which two of his books? One, Ar-Rad al-Jahmiyyah. And the second book, An-Naqd ala Bishr al-Marisi. An-Naqd ala Bishr al-Marisi. These two books, he used to advise us with great emphasis, read these books. These books are very beneficial. Every student of the Sunnah should read these books. And inside this book is the Aqeedah of the Sahaba, the Tabi'un and the A'imma. Subhanallah. Now let's see what's inside this book. This An-Naqd ala Bishr al-Marisi. The book which Shaykhul Islam is greatly admires. And he's saying inside this, this is the book of the Sahaba, the Aqeedah, sorry, of Sahaba, Tabi'un and the A'imma. I'll give you a few quotes. Inside this book of the Darimi, the Mubtadi', An-Naqd ala Bishr al-Marisi. He's mentioned on page 20, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yataharrak idha yasha. He moves whenever he wishes. Yaqum wa yajlis idha yasha. He stands and sits whenever he wishes. Why? لأن أمارة ما بين الحي والميت التحرك. Because the sign of living and dead is to move. Therefore, everything that is living should move. So therefore, Allah also moves. He's got body movement. He has got body movement. He's mentioned on page 24. This Ad-Darimi guy in the same book, which these people admire, that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala has got a limit. There are many evidences that Allah has got a limit, had. And whoever refuses and doesn't acknowledge that Allah has a limit, فَقَدْ كَفَرْ, he's a kafir. فَقَدْ كَفَرْ, he is a kafir. According to this statement, Imam Tahawi is a kafir. According to this statement, Imam Abu Hanifa is a kafir. According to this statement, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal is a kafir. نَعُوذِ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And this is a book that Shaykh al-Islam would greatly advise. Moving further. On page 29, he has mentioned that Allah has two physical hands, and through this he has created Adam. وَمَسَّهُ بِهِمَا مَسِيسًا. And with these hands he touched Allah, with these hands he touched Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Subhanallah, this is supposed to be the aqeedah of the Sahaba. This is supposed to be the aqeedah of the Tabi'un. This is supposed to be the aqeedah of the A'imah, according to Shaykh al-Islam and his student. On page 74, he has mentioned An-Naqd ala Bish al-Marisi, the Darimi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sitting on his arsh. He is sitting on his arsh and he's left places all around the arsh. On page 85, he has mentioned. Now you can know where these people get the Aqeedah from. When they say the Salaf, they're talking about the deviated Salaf. When they say we follow the Salaf, they are talking about the deviated Salaf. They don't follow the pious Salaf. They don't follow the pious Salaf. They follow the deviated Salaf. Because Salaf means those that have come before us. Amongst them are many deviated people. He has mentioned that if Allah wished, He can settle on the back of a mosquito. He can settle on the back of a... Ibn Taymiyyah has also mentioned this inside his book. He has mentioned in a different book, same book, page 96. That we know that Allah has a place. We know Allah has a place on His throne. And next to His throne, there is nothing with Him. There is no human sitting with Him. لَيْسَ مَعَهُ هُنَاكَ إِنْسِ. There is no human sitting with Him. And there is no jinn sitting with Him. وَلَا بِجُنْبِهِ حُشٌ. And there is no toilet beside, on the side of Him. نَعُوذِ بِاللَّهِ. حُشٌ. When a person relieves himself, that's hush. There's no hush on the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا مِرْحَاظ. There's no toilet there. وَلَا شَيْطَان. There's no shaitan next to Him also. So Allah sitting on His arsh and none of these things are sitting next to Him. نَعُوذِ بِاللَّهِ. Page 96. Page 100. He said, رَأْسُ الْجَبَلْ أَقْرَبْ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ أَسْفَلِهِ. That the peak of the mountain, the top of the mountain is more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the bottom of the mountain. ورأس المنارة أقرب إلى الله من أسفلها. And the top of a minaret is more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the bottom of the minaret. He further mentions, subhanallah, that we will not acknowledge that every creation, that every all actions are created. Subhanallah, listen to this. We will never acknowledge that all actions are created. This Ad-Darimi is saying on page 121 of his book, An-Naqd ala Bishr al-Marisi, who Shaykh al-Islam greatly advises, and he said this is the Aqeedah of the Sahaba, and who Ibn Qayyim has also given targheeb to us. He's saying that the actions, all of them are not created. We don't accept this. Why? Because there's ijma again. These people, it's part of their nature to say ijma and Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. They just say it for the fun of it. See, ijma is a consensus of the ummah. The harakah, movement, nuzul, descending, mash, walking, harwala, running, istiwa al-arsh, and settling above the throne, on the throne. This is all qadeem. It's not been created. I.e., Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is pre-eternity, His being. Therefore, these actions have been there since the beginning of time. Pre-eternity also. They're qadeem. They're not being created. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. This goes against the hadith. كان الله ولم يكن شيء غيره. That Allah existed and nothing apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala existed. Further on, he's mentioning, subhanallah, this is something which will make your, subhanallah, page 36, same book, he says, yanzilullahu fi baha'ihi wa jamalihi. Page 36, Ad-Darimi is mentioning, the Mubtada', not the Sunan one. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends with His beauty. وَمَعَهُ مَا شَأَ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. And with Him are angels, what he, however, how whichever He wishes, how many He wishes. And listen to this. أَلَى مُجَنَّبَتِهِ الْيُسْرَى جَهَنَّمْ. When He descends, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He descends to the sky, He has angels with Him, and on His wing and flank is Jahannam. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. On the flank and wing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Jahannam. Now this is supposed to be the aqeedah of the Sahaba. This is supposed to be the aqeedah of the A'imma. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, from such a lie. There's many other quotes from this book. So this is the book which Shaykhul Islam Ibn Taymiyyah is telling us, that whoever wants to learn the Sunnah, read this book. Ibn Qayyim is saying, I'm also advising you, because my Shaykh advised me, if you want to know the true creed of the Salaf, then read this book. La hawla, Allah save us from this book. A question arises. The question is, that if Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah is such a great scholar, if he's a great scholar, why on earth did he blind follow his ustad, his sheikh? Yeah? So I'll just give you a few quotes regarding this. Hafiz Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, has mentioned Ad-Dura al-Kamina, fi A'lam al-Mi'at al-Thamina, volume 4, page 21, regarding Ibn Qayyim, ghalaba alayhi hubbu Ibn Taymiyyah, that the love of Ibn Taymiyyah had overpowered Ibn Qayyim. حتى كان لا يخرج عن شيء من أقواله, to such an extent that he will not again go against any of his statements. He will blindly follow him. بل ينتصر له في جميع ذلك, but he will help Ibn Taymiyyah all the time. وهو الذي هذب كتبه, he was the one who refined his books. ونشر علمه, and propagated his knowledge. واعتقل مع ابن تيمية في القلعة بعد أن أهينا, and he was tied with Ibn Taymiyyah inside a castle after that he was disgraced. وطيف به على جمل مضروبا بالدرة, and he was taken around on a camel in the state that he was hit with a whip. He was hit with a whip. On volume 4, same book, Ad-Dur al-Kamina, volume 4, page 22, he has mentioned, وَهُوَ مُسْهِبْ, that Ibn Qayyim used to write in great length, طَوِيلُ النَّفَسْ فِي مُصَنَّفَاتِهِ, and he had great caliber in writing in his books. يَتَعَانَا الْإِيضَى جُهْدَ, and he will support in explaining the efforts of his sheikh. فَيُسْهِبْ جِدًّا, and he would elaborate on this. وَمُعْظَمُهَا مِنْ كَلَامِ الشَّيْخِ, and most of these his statements were from his Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah. يَتَصَرَّ فِي ذَلِكَ, would have great tasarruf inside this. وَلَهُ فِي ذَلِكَ مَلَكَةٌ قَوِيَّةٌ, and he would have great strong talent in, you know, proving his argument, even though it was all false, most of it, when it came to aqidah. وَلَا يَزَالْ يُدَنْدِنُ حَوْلَ مُفَرَدَاتِهِ, and he would hum and chant around the isolated opinions of Ibn Taymiyyah. The isolated opinions. That's why some scholars have said, that Ibn Taymiyyah went again in 60 masail. In 60 masail, he went against consensus. وَيَنْصُرُهَا, and he would help Ibn Taymiyyah. وَيَحْتَجْ لَهَا, and he will use him as evidence. Hafiz al-Dhahabi, inside his book, Mu'jam al-Muhaddithin, volume 1, page 269, is mentioned that Ibn Qayyim, مُعْجَب بِرَأْيِهِ, he was amazed and he was an admirer of his own opinion. جَرِيءٌ عَلَى الْأُمُورِ, he had great audacity upon matters. غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him. So this is Ibn Qayyim's, rahmatullah, Ijtima' Jewish Islamiyyah. This book is based on fabrication, is based on interpolation, is based on misquotation and misinterpretation of the likes of Imam Tabari rahimahullah. He has misquoted him, he has misquoted a hadith, he has forged words inside hadith, and he has advised us to read a book which la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. After reading a few lines, a person, hair on the body, stands.